your party is part of this coalition of Barisan Nasional. And your biggest component party is AMNO. Okay. Now, would MCA would have a say or influence in all the policy, or is all be dictated by AMNO? And MCA, we just have to follow. But it looks to us, obviously, in that way. Because a lot of things have been said, detected by even the Hami, you know, by Ismail, Sobri. And I think some of the things they said, they don't even consult the component parties of Barisan Nasional. They just say, you know, to please their own constituents. Basically, perhaps to please the Malay constituency. So I think this is something we want to know. Would MCA have an equal voice within the coalition if you form the government?
MCA is very present. Two things. One is leadership. Number two is the number of parliamentary seats in the government. If we have a lot of seats for the good leadership, I think it's a point. Same thing like for any coalition. Right? But if you have strong leadership, you only have two or six or one seat, I think you're also weak. That's life. Right? So that's why, to me, I want to take Damansara as a place where I have to test and get support from the residents here so that we have this urban voice within Barisan Nasional. So that government policies or whatever policies that make at the federal level will include your voice. For example, this PJDD, overdevelopment issues, Damansara, all this we have to tackle. Otherwise, we will just be left like that. See what's happening in Damansara over the past 12 years. I think it's not for the worse. Because these guys want to make more and more policies to benefit rural Malaysia. I want to talk to them. I say, there's not, of course, the margin, but I mean, of course, if you say like that, then I will have to win these rural seats. But once we have a strong representation on the government side, then I think policies will be made to reflect the aspirations of city folks. Because living in city hall is not easy. Not everyone in Damansara is as well off as Damansara Jaya residents. There are a lot of poor people out there. Alright? These are the people that live out. That's why for me, service is very important. Delivery is very important. You serve, you don't deliver for service. You need to be consistent. Say what you mean what you say. Very, very important. If you don't do any of this, then why are you the member of parliament, or state assembly, or even the council? To me, it's very, very important. So I think if MCA continue to have one or two seats in the coalition, Susana, that's why I think we need more representation, more elected representatives within the party itself, so that within Barisan Nasional, at least we have a say. I think those days when MCA was strong, came out of that. You know, then, of course, things change. Nothing is forever in life. Huh? It's a cycle. We may come back again, we may not have to go. Alright? You see, like the last time, we show one entity, you will punish for it, you know? That is punished. Alright? And I don't think we need another one entity to happen again. That's why you see this time around. We have to correct ourselves. And hopefully, people will give us a chance to recover. That's all we have to say. Well, it's a bad experience. 2018 punished severely for that. The mistakes that you've done.
Thank you. Anyone?